behind him. There's another right hand to the nose. Here's the heavy artillery from Eko Roni Saputra. And went for the big takedown. Goes inside a half guard.
Ooh, that was nice. He threw those hands with some heat to enter into that takedown. I think he was looking for the knockout first, but the takedown just sort of happened. See, this is what Eko does. He's a really good back taker. Look at him. You can see Chan Rotana is trying to press his back up against the wall so Eko Roni can't take it and get that other hook in. See how Eko is trying to get that left leg in? He's going to try to scoop that leg around, grab the other side. Chan's got to be very careful right here. Oh.
This could be the beginning of the end. As Mitch said, this is Eko Roni Saputraville. This is Eko Land. Not where Chan wants to be. Eko squeezing. Chan trying to find a way back to his feet to defend here. And Eko climbs on the back of Chan Rotana.
Eko's got a crazy squeeze. We talked about it in the walk, Michael. Chan Rotana's got to try to fight those hands. He's got to try to protect his neck.
Is it going to be another first round finish for Eko Roni Saputra? It looks like it. It is. Eko Roni Saputra's done it again.
Wow. Once again, look at that right hand. Left hand shoots in for a double.
Gets the takedown here. Goes inside a half guard. And then the beginning of the end. Climbs the back of Chan Rotana. Chan's going to fall back in a moment. This will do it. It gets cinched even tighter once he goes back here. That's it. Locked in, all over. Chan nowhere to go but tap.
Go, Ronnie. Hammer fist strike. Calls for the elbow again from the corner. Ramon's got to find a way to get off his back here. Dominance from Eko Roni Saputra. High knee there. Forearm across the side of the head. Drops the elbow once more. It's all good scoring stuff here for Eko Roni. Drives in the knuckles on the right hand. Faces exposed on Ramon Gonzalez.
Ramon Gonzalez needs to let go of the head of Eko Roni. He's trying to keep him close so Eko Roni can't posture up and start dropping any ground and pound. But he's giving him control of Ramon Gonzalez. Ramon Gonzalez needs to slow things down, but Eko Roni is forcing him to make some cardinal mistakes.
Both men have 100% finishing rights to Eko Roni.
Look at it again. You can see he had one hook in on the one side. He adjusted his position, and then he slowly gets the choke in, right? Applies that squeeze. Doesn't even have the legs on the inside of the body. Only has one leg. See, you don't need both legs sometimes when you got to squeeze like Eko Roni Saputra. And then Ramon Gonzalez was forced to tap. That's a beautiful submission, Michael.
His way back up to his feet. Good job, Y2K.
Aggressively, Eko Roni Saputra letting right kick down back to the canvas. What can he do from here, Eko Roni? He's got such tremendous power. And Mitch, the amount of improvement that Saputra has shown over the last 18 months, just phenomenal.
Yeah, he's definitely evolved in a lot of different areas, no pun intended. But Y2K is doing a good job of controlling some of these positions and staying safe. This is what Y2K said he worked very hard on, wrestling defense and staying on his feet.
Inside the guard of Y2K, postures up, a hammer fist strike, then drives the knuckles down to the jaw.
See, this is one of the biggest problems with grappling with Eko. He moves so well. He drops into a leg, entangle me.
It's over! World champion tilts on your hands in Eko Roni Saputra. Look at the finish here. Fabulous finish from an absolute machine of a man. Someone to be excited about. Eko Roni Saputra made it look easy.
It's okay getting punched in the face. That comes from decades of Kung Kamai. He's okay to sit there and get smashed on because he's trying to reverse, but now he's giving up a bad spot as Eko Roni Saputra might be searching for a rear naked choke.
Gonza John, all guts and intestinal fortitude, but it could be over now. Is this it? Is this the beginning of the end? The crowd go wild. That's good night, freaking Irene.
After submission after submission, the Americana wasn't working. The arm triangle wasn't working. All right, let me punch you in the face until you give up your back and I can give you that rear naked choke. And that's the one that seals.
Eko Roni Saputra, the big overhand right
to perfection. Look at this. Over it goes, hits the button, hits the jaw. He was out. He was astral traveling before he even hit the canvas.
Oh, look how he set that up, Michael. He comes right down the middle with a sneaky right hand and then comes over the guard with that right hand, touches him on the button. Check this out, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, what a thing of letting go with those hands, and now he's inside control, starting to drop that ground and pound. Now he's going to look for a far arm Americana right there. Good job by Silveraju. He needs to get that underhook on that left side so he can start working his way onto his side. He's got to try to not stay flat. He's got to turn to his right side, create that space, and get moving. But that underhook on that left arm, if he can get underneath the arm of Eko Roni Saputra, that is going to enable him to turn onto his side and start to work his escapes. But right now, he is stuck in this position.
Eko Roni Saputra hunting for a first round finish. Mitch, what is going on?
Get up his own stuff. Look at this. He attacks. First, he started attacking the far arm, and then he goes after a key lock submission here with his leg. Look, he shoves it underneath his calf and then starts torquing on his hips and pulls his hip up. That's a shoulder lock with his leg. That's nasty.
On his first two matches by guillotine choke, making his pro debut in September 2016, then went on a two-match skid when he hit one championship. Oh, Eko Roni Saputra!
Wow. Yeah, that was a problem. Kajikan goes to throw that big right hand, and then the arm just pops right out. Once he